Hi guys, and welcome to Fandom Newbie. My name is Shruti, and today I'm going to be talking about 7 Indian books that I am dying to read. So I recently came across all of these 7 titles, and I seriously want to like kick myself that I haven't like found these earlier, because they all sound so amazing, they all sound so captivating, and I'm so excited to start reading them. So I thought I'd share them with you guys first. So yeah, let's just jump right into the video. The first one that I want to talk about is Hunted by the Sky by Tanaz Bhatena. This book totally gives me Ember in the Ashes vibes, and if you guys have been following me on my channel for a while now, you know that the Ember in the Ashes series is one of my all-time favorite book series. Now, this book is a fantasy book, and it seems to have quite a cool magic system within it. The main character is Gul, and the story basically follows this main character as her entire family has been murdered by a ruthless ruler. Now, because of this, she basically runs away and she joins a band of rebel women. And these women teach her how to hone her magic so that she can get her vengeance against this ruler. This book seems like it has all the things that a perfect YA novel should have, like a strong female protagonist, a magic system that seems quite interesting, and also like a really bad autocratic ruler. Like, this is like, these are the things that are there in every single YA book, and this book seems to have all of them. Plus, the backdrop is medieval India, which I think is just so interesting and will make this book so relatable. So I'm really, really looking forward to reading this one. The next one that I want to talk about is actually a series of books, and that is the Taj Mahal Trilogy by Indu Sundaresan. This trilogy obviously consists of 3 books, The 20th Wife, The Feast of Roses, and Shadow Princess. And all of these books are basically about the Mughal Empire in India. Now, it focuses on the reign of 3 Mughal emperors, namely Akbar, Jahangir, and Shah Jahan. But all the books are actually from the perspective of their wives rather than the actual Mughal emperor. The crux of the story is basically the life of Mehrunisa, who is Jahangir's 20th wife, hence the name of the first book. But the story basically follows Mehrunisa's story right from when she's a child to when she grows up and marries Emperor Jahangir, and also their tumultuous love story. Through this tumultuous love story and through the life story of this queen, in that sense, we get to have an insight into the Mughal Empire, how things were ruled back then, the lives of these women, like the wives of the Mughal emperors. And that is what I'm really, really intrigued about. I've always been intrigued by the Mughal Empire, especially since I watched Jodha Akbar, the movie. Like, I've always been very, very intrigued by that time in history. And yeah, that's why I'm really excited to read this trilogy, because I've heard very good things about it. Like, it's got very high ratings on Goodreads. So yeah, I'm seriously excited to start this trilogy. The next one that I want to talk about is Daughter from a Wishing Tree by Sudha Murthy. Now, I've never read a Sudha Murthy book before, but I've heard such good things about her writing and such good things about her books. And even though I know she has a few other books which are a lot more famous, I want to start with this one because the premise just seems so amazing. This book is basically a collection of short stories which focuses on the women in Indian mythology and talks about the remarkable things that they have done. Now, when it comes to Indian mythology, I've said this a few times on my channel before actually, that I feel that we've always seen things from a male point of view. Like, a lot of the stories that are told, the men are basically the heroes, and the men are the ones that go to war and fight and do remarkable things, and the men are the ones that are shown with a lot of strength and power and things like that. Whereas the women are always kind of in the background. There are women in Indian mythology who have had like really strong roles to play, but they always seem to be in the background. So I'm really excited that this book basically brings these women out into the foreground and tells their stories and talks about the great things that they have done. The next book that I want to talk about is Empire by Devi Yashodharan. This book revolves around the Chola dynasty in India. Now, our main character in this book is Aramis, who is a Greek girl, and basically she has surrendered to the Indian army commander named Anantha, because the Indian Chola army has completely destroyed the Greek army, and basically now they've taken captives, and Aramis is one of them. Now, because she is captured by the Chola army, she has to now grow up among her captors, among her enemies. But in growing up, she also like learns things like archery, she learns how to fight, and she becomes quite a good warrior. So good that she actually is called upon to be one of the bodyguards for the Chola king. Now, amidst all this, of course, the Chola king has conquered many lands, but he's still hungry to conquer more, because of which he's planning an extremely brutal war that Aramis is kind of forced to go into, and we don't really know whether she's going to survive it or not. So yeah, this is basically a historical fiction book that is set during the Chola dynasty, and it just sounds very interesting. Like, I'm really interested because we have a foreigner female protagonist within an Indian context, and I think that like contrast is something that is very interesting to read about. The melding of the two and this coming of age story also, which I think it will be about Aramis, is something that I think will be very, very interesting to read. And I'm quite excited to read this one as well. The next one on my list is The Forest of Enchantment by Chitra Banerjee. Now, I recently read The Palace of Illusions and I really, really, really loved it. Like, I love Chitra Banerjee's writing. I loved Draupadi's perspective to the things that happened in the Mahabharata. And because of all of this, I had to pick up her next book, especially when it is a retelling of the Ramayana from Sita's point of view. I feel that Chitra Banerjee has a really, like, she's really good at capturing nuances of female characters and giving them a voice and giving them a lot of character and really going into their psyche and understanding what they go through, what they feel, the emotions that they feel. I feel that she captures them really well, and she gives like a really fresh perspective to these old epics. Because of this, I'm really excited to read The Forest of Enchantment, because I think it's going to be another amazing book, and yeah, I can't wait to get my hands on it. The next book is The Devourers by Indra Das. Now, this book has something to do with werewolves, and I am so intrigued because of that. The story follows a man named Alok, who is a professor, and one night, basically, Alok meets a man who claims to be a shapeshifter, and this shapeshifter gives Alok the task of transcribing an ancient text that is written by another shapeshifter who devours humans. Now, through the writing of this ancient text, basically, Alok comes to know about this entire world of shapeshifters, and it is like he discovers a world that is beyond anything that he's ever imagined or dreamed of. And I guess he somehow kind of becomes a part of that world. So yeah, this is another fantasy book which I thought was really intriguing, because it talks about a concept of werewolves, apparently, which, I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but I feel that it's a very like Western concept, especially like, you know, the full moon and someone turning into a werewolf. I feel it's something that's very Western. So to see how it's given kind of an Indian spin and how it's kind of incorporated into like an Indian context is something that I'm very excited to read about. And the last book that I want to talk about is When Love Came Calling by Preeti Shenoy. Now, this book is basically about a love story between two polar opposites. Arush is a shy boy who lives in the UK and who dreams of visiting India. Pooja is a feisty, fiery, energetic young girl who lives in India. Now, both of them coincidentally meet in Kerala and their love story blossoms. Beyond this, I don't really know that much, but I have heard that Preeti Shenoy writes amazingly. Like, she has a really good writing style, and the way she crafts love stories or just stories in general is very captivating. And I really want to read good Indian contemporary fiction books, because I feel like contemporary fiction is a genre that's so relatable. So I really want to read good Indian contemporary fiction books, which is why I'm also excited to pick up this one. So yeah, those are the 7 Indian books that I am really, really dying to read. Like, they just all sound so amazing and so wonderful. So yeah, I'm really, really excited to read these. If you guys like this video, then give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment down below letting me know if you've heard of any of these books, if you've read them, what did you think about them? Or also let me know which are some Indian books that you guys are dying to read. Give me some more recommendations, because I'm really trying to read a lot more Indian literature. And of course, if you like videos like these, then do subscribe to my channel for more book-related videos. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!